shoes permit a skewed amalgamation of shoes in a less than perfect situation. Spitballing ink scribbles out of a third grade playbook. This five subject notebook looks like a spell check's worst nightmare. Silently catcalling deep wrinkles by a mode of looks and stares instead, a mode of transportation. This takes you to Union Station. Check stall number two. S-I-N, confident pen, a fixation you have for the criminal to return. Over-analysis concludes these words to the postmodern. How can one reflection reflect anything other than itself? A discern for communicative stealth, a return to plentiful irony. Life is too too. Life is too. Life is too turbulent not to write about. There's liberation in fluency, an ongoing dedication to an aesthetic. You found yours at Goodwill, wrapped up in relics in an attic and eccentric landfill, where anxiety is dealt by the trunk, and anxiousness is greeted as an educated beast. Sort of a tip of that hat as gold coins flip into the collection vat. The celebrated jest, the relatively sensitive part of the episode that you skip. For it makes you uncomfortable. Four poorly painted walls watching pig-like horoscopes. Four missed calls vibrate on your pillow. Four sorely awaited hours repurposing Hawaiian sweet dinner rolls. Collecting fingernail rubbish and grease on the soles of your feet. Paying for the nearest street person's midnight cigarillo. So petrified by bloodshot eyes that you nearly capsize your manual machine. And not just bloodshot, but diseased. Like the trembling knees from before, the steel-toed stomp from the shoes that he wore was the first inclination of the interview that increased. Never violent, unpoliced, but certainly mistreated. The Lord's name was uttered. A Walkman appeared, and life circled away. That damn bottle never surfaced, but somewhere in the billows of your closet is a coat hanger, midway on the rings, that reads, "Save these in case I need to help you fix something."